A very good morning and welcome to the video lecturer part number 1 on operation research. As we all know that after the industrial revolution and then later the scientific management, man has continuously looked for optimization of time, efforts and resources etc. in order to improve the productivity and hence maximizing the profits. So let us imagine some of the situations which are most commonly encountered in the business of the world. First one, a person has 2500 rupees on hand. He wants to buy a hens and sell the eggs they hatch to make a profit. He finds out that old hens can be bought for 100 rupees each and young hens can be bought for 200 rupees each. The old hens lay 3 eggs per week and young ones lay 5 eggs per week, each egg being worth 10 rupees. It cost 10 rupees per week to feed a old hen, while for a young one it is 18 rupees. Assuming that the person cannot house more than 20 hens, how many old hens and how many young ones he should buy to maximize a profit? So this is one of the interesting problem that can be solved with the help of a OR technique. As I said, OR is a mathematical technique which is used to solve the complex problems. Okay, so here the problem looks very simple, but it is a complicated because there are restrictions are given with respect to the money, okay, and number of hens. So only you can buy 20 hens, okay, which have two kinds of hens, and you know their amount is given, so which is all restrictions are given. So and even person has only 2500 rupees on hand, so within this 2500 rupees only he has to buy old and young hens, the mixture of the two hens. Then you know he has to buy only 20 hens, more than 20 hens are restricted. So in this condition, how a person handle the situation of buying the mixture of old and young hens to maximize a profit? So this is one problem where we can able to apply AOR and get the somewhat better solution. Instead of worse solution, good solution we can able to get it. Let us see one more question. A farmer wants to plant coconut trees and mango trees in a land of 4400 square meters area. See here, a farmer wanted to plant a coconut tree and mango tree. So there are two kinds of a tree he has to plant, and the space restriction is given, that is land, in terms of land, that is 4400 square meter area. Within this area he has to plant the two plants. Each coconut tree requires at least 15 square meter, means even a restriction is given on a coconut tree as well as mango tree also. The annual water requirement of a coconut tree is 30 units, while for a mango tree it is 20 units per tree. Okay, a maximum of 3300 units of water is available annually. Again, this is one of the restriction. It is estimated that the ratio of the number of mango trees to the number of coconut trees should not be less than 6 by 19 and not more than 17 by 8. The ratio of their trees are also given, which is not less than 6 by 19 and not more than 17 by 8. If the return per coconut tree is expected to be 1.5 times that of the mango tree, what should be the number of trees of each type to be planted so that the expected returns are maximum? So here also, a person wanted to plant a tree, that is a farmer wanted to plant a coconut tree as well as mango tree with the some of the restrictions which has mentioned in this problem. So here also we can able to apply a OR, that is a mathematical technique, to find the best solution to get the maximum profit. So this is about the brief introduction to OR. Then let us see definition of the OR. definition of operation research. So the different different scientists have prepared their own sentences regarding OR. That is, OR is a scientific method of providing executive departments with a quantitative basis for decision regarding the operation under their control. So this is given by the Morse and Kimball. OR is applied decision theory. It uses any scientific, mathematical or logical means to attempt to cope with a problem that confronts the executive when he tries to achieve a rationality in dealing with his decision problem. This is given by Miller and Starr. OR is an experimental and applied science devoted to observing, understanding and predicting the behavior of purposeful man-machine system and OR workers are actively engaged in applying this knowledge to practical problems in business, government and society. And the best definition is given by T.L. Sati. OR is the art of giving bad answers to the problems which otherwise have worse answers. So these are the some of the definitions of the operation research. Okay, now let us look at the scope or application areas of the operation research. So first one, the industry. Industries always look for an optimum utilization of the resources such as man, materials, machines, money and time. Several OR tools like LPP, that is linear programming problems, transportation, inventory control, sequencing are used in solving the industrial problems. Let us detail study about these things in the next coming chapters. Okay, next one, in the finance, how this operation research will help you in the finance is that determination of the best product mix for maximization of the profits. Just now I have given you the example that how you can able to buy two kinds of hens to achieve the maximum of the profit. So here also the determination of the best product mix for maximization of the profits, that can be given by the OR technique. Then evolution of the best replacement policies, cash flow analysis and capital budgeting, optimal utilization of the finance for better results. So these all the properties come under finance. Then in the agriculture, optimum allocation of the land to various crops in accordance with the resources utilized as well as the climate condition. See, with the available resources, how a farmer can able to plant his trees, and how he can able to go for a water irrigation and all. So this is all given by the OR in the field of agriculture. See, the second point, optimum distribution of the water and other resources. So this is all done by the OR technique. Next application is in the government, to maximize the per capita income with the minimum resources. So definitely whenever the cash flow cash related objectives will be there, where we will be having the minimum resources and obtaining the maximum profit. So that is what we needed to concentrate, and to allocate finance to various ministries with a view to maximize the returns, and to alleviate poverty and hunger through better utilization of the funds and other resources. So these all come under in the governments. And in the marketing sector, to determine the best distribution strategies with the help of a transportation and traveling salesman algorithms. Here suppose, for example, if a traveling salesman who wanted to sell his goods, and he has to transport from one city to another city via some other cities. So how well he reached all the cities and sold his sell his goods and obtain the maximum profit. So this is all come under the category of marketing, right? And to determine the selection of the best advertising media for maximum and appropriate reach. So advertisement also play a very important role, as we I've discussed in the managements and all. So, how well you advertise your product to have a better, a profit. So that is all given by the OWA technique in the field of marketing. And to determine how, when, and what to purchase at minimum cost. Then, in the production management, to schedule and sequence work activities according to the production plan. Suppose you have two machines and there are so many number of jobs, or if there are only two jobs and there are different machines, how sequence of operation you have to perform to have the better better maximum the profit and minimum cost, and the idle time of the machine should be reduced. So this is all come under the in the production management to calculate the optimum product mix. Next one, limitations of the OR. So first one, a formulation of the problem has to be accurate and well defined. If not, the solution may not fetch the desired result. This is all a known thing, right? If the problem is not defined correctly, then we cannot able to get the solution right. So formulation is to be very important. Then second point, formulation of the problem also involve extensive collection of data which may consume time and money. Okay. Third one, OR involves any only quantifiable factors like money, time, space. So OR actually concentrates on the money, time and space, whereas it does not count about human intuition, experience, reputation, it won't consider. Okay. Hence, if it is not considered these things, then this will be a biggest drawback of the operation research. Fine. Next one, OR analysis and solutions are mainly based on the past observations. Okay. But there is no guarantee that same set of conditions would continue in future also. See, OR technique the solution obtained from the OR is all about the statistics and probability. You won't get the same answer every time. Even though the same conditions are there, you won't get the same or the repeated solution for the same engineering problems. Hence, there is no guarantee that the same set of conditions would continue in the future. Right? Then the whole process of decision making through OR may result in higher costs as well as delay in the implementation. So, implementing the OR is not that easy, okay, and hence it results in higher costs. And the last point is, it is not easy to translate complex real life practical situations with a lot of variables into simple procedure to be able to be solved by OR tools and techniques. Definitely OR is applicable or it is applied whenever the complex real life problems exist. So it is not that easy to translate a complex problem into a very simple problem. Okay. So this is about the limitations of the OR. So in the next class, we'll discuss the some of the phases of the OR. Fine. Thank you.